I realize that so much of quarterbacking is summed up in the ability to again and again make great decisions with the football in your hands. I had to learn this lesson the hard way many times, and I remember my sophomore year playing at Notre Dame. We were down by 3 late in the game, and we got into field goal range, and I looked over to the sideline for the next play with just under 30 seconds left, and my quarterback coach, Dave Warner, looked at me and pointed to his temples, and I knew what that meant. It meant make a great decision here, be smart. We have a field goal in the bag to tie the game, so just be smart with the football. Well, famous last words, on the next play, I was blitzed and threw the ball over the middle and it was intercepted, and we lost the game. And I remember picking myself up off the turf with a piece of grass still stuck in my helmet from getting hit and pulling that grass out, listening to the deafening sound of 80,000 people cheering my failure. When I look back now, I realize that decision-making is not just quarterbacking, it's life. It's a far more important game than the game of football. And I brought my Bible up here. We have a playbook on the football field. Us quarterbacks study it relentlessly, but this is the playbook for life. The Bible makes it very clear that the best decision you will ever make, far beyond where to throw a football, is the decision to make of who will be the master of your life. As I walked off the field those days, a second thought beyond, oh no, I just made a bad decision, a second thought would often go through my head, and the thought would go like this: thank you, God, that my life is not built on football. Because if my life is built on football, it just crumbled. I had made a decision, a good decision, many years ago as a young man to build my life on this book, the truth of God's word, and to allow Him to direct the course of my life, wherever it may go, good or bad, but to trust and obey Him, to make Jesus my master. And as a result, I believe I've lived, played football, and led my family with an unexplainable peace in the midst of whatever life throws at me. And so I'm here this morning to ask you, who have you chosen to be your master?